Hi, everybody. February is African American History Month, and it is February, and it's important that we talk about some African American artists. Now, the one I want to talk about today, his name was Jacob Lawrence. Now, Jacob Lawrence was an artist that he was born in 1917, and he lived all the way up until year 2000. And when he was 23 years old, he created something called the Migration Series. Now, when an artist makes a series of what they call a series of art, that's when he or she creates several different art pieces all on the same subject. And the Migration Series, it was about a time in American history when a lot of African-American people that were living in small towns and rural places down south in the southern United States moved up north to big cities to find work, to find jobs. And with that, they really changed the culture of the entire United States.
When the artist Jacob Lawrence was 23 years old, he got a grant from the government for $1,500, which was a lot of money back then, to paint 63 wood panels called the Migration Series. The Migration Series shows a time in history when a lot of African Americans left southern states to find jobs in northern states in larger cities. The series came out in the year 1941. Jacob Lawrence's parents were some of these people that left southern states to come find jobs in the city. And this series of paintings shows a lot of what was going on in the African-American communities in Harlem, New York. This is all part of what is called the Harlem Renaissance, which is a period of American history where there was a lot of African-American music and art and poetry and writing that became very popular. This series of paintings showed the lives that African-Americans were living in Harlem, but also showed some of their struggles, like violence and racism. Like this painting that shows a restaurant where African American people weren't allowed to eat with the white people that were eating at the same restaurant.
I'm also gonna read you a story that was written by the author Sharifa Rhodes Pitt, and it was about Jacob Lawrence when he was a boy living in Harlem, New York.
Jake makes a world. Jacob Lawrence, an artist in Harlem. By Sharifa Rhodes Pitt and illustrated by Christopher Myers. In the morning, Jake watches the sun wake up. He makes a big stretch, and the sun stretches too. With first light, the dancing dark shadows begin to fade. Then the colors come again. Yellow, orange, and blue on the quilt that covers Jake and his brother's bed. Mother's paper flowers in pink and red. His feet sink deep into the thick blue rug. When his toes touch the ground, it's like the sky upside down. When Jake moved to this city, this New York, to the neighborhood called Harlem, to live with mother again, these familiar things from his old home in Philadelphia greeted him like long-lost friends. Outside Jake's building, men play chess and checkers, balancing their boards on their knees. Older boys sell fruit from a wagon, or ice from a bucket, shouting for people to come down and get it. Mothers walk fast to work and more work. Signs promise home-cooked meals for 15 cents and shoeshine to make you brand new. A preacher in a hat shouts and sings about God. A newsboy tells the stories of the day from downtown and around the world, but tells them with a tune. At the corner, a short man stands on a stepladder telling everybody how we will get the freedom we need. Most days after school, Jake goes to a place called Utopia Children's House. The word utopia means that it is a special place, unlike any other. For Jake, it is. At Utopia House, Jake makes things with his hands. He carves a block of soap into a fish. He sews scraps of leather into a secret pouch. With watercolors, he swirls the shadows that dance on his wall at dawn and the patterns of the rugs in his living room. Jake takes a stick of charcoal and draws a pair of eyes to see everything the people on the street see. He draws one pair of ears to hear all the shouts and songs, one mouth to carry all their voices. All the faces Jake sees on the street become one face. Jake shows this new face to his teacher, who smiles and nods and says, "You should see this very old mask from Africa." Jake stares at the mask for a long while, and then he makes his own mask from brown paper bags and glue and paint. When he is done, the mask smiles at him. Jake takes a shoebox, and in the box he tries to fit the whole street. Inside are cardboard chessmen, tiny boys folded from construction paper, and mothers walking fast to work, wearing dresses cut from magazines. He stacks the matchboxes to make buildings and paves the street with sandpaper. Jake has made a world, a small piece of this place called Harlem. It is now his home. Jake's Harlem has all the shouts and songs and notes of the Harlem outside. But here, they are not sounds, they are colors. They are shadows dancing. They are rhythms. They are light.
Now, we are going to do some artwork that is kind of like one of Jacob Lawrence's Migration Series painting, his panel number one.
The very first panel in the Migration Series.
I hope you like doing this project. I liked making mine, and I hope you liked learning about Jacob Lawrence, and I hope to talk to everybody soon. Bye, everybody.